y'all doing? It's Tksmithjr Jr. Alright, last time we discussed trust issues and how sometimes we allow the baggage from our past to be the reason why we don't trust someone currently in our life. Stop blocking your blessings. God's trying to bless you with someone right now and trying to help you connect with an individual to help achieve your goals. Allow them in. Stop putting the past situations into your current situation. But I also said for my individuals that are in a relationship that they're putting that stress upon you and you have done nothing to lose their trust. Let's talk about getting that spark back. When you're dealing with someone for so long, like I always say, we get into bad routines, to ones that are really old. You need to keep that spark up. You want that person to still be with you. So you need to take advantage of all the things that you know about them and implement that while you're in a relationship with them. There's nothing wrong with being spontaneous by doing things that will just catch them off guard to continue to intrigue their mind. Ways of how you can intrigue an individual mind can be, you know, they had a long day at work today and they've been texting you all day. So then somewhere in your spirit, you're like, you know what? I'm gonna cook them a good meal. I'm gonna play them their favorite music in the background. To my ladies, you might wanna even sexy it up, put some lingerie on and be in the kitchen getting it on. I mean, as far as cooking y'all, in your lingerie. Do things that will just keep the relationship intriguing and keeping that spark up. You see something out and you know that it'd be something that will bring a smile to their face, then just get it. It's not always about how much money that you spend. And sometimes it's just about just knowing them well enough to know the gifts that they will like. A simple gesture of flowers, keep that spark flamed. When you are with someone, want to allow another individual to come in between your relationship because there is no longer a spark. A simple midnight text or a phone call will mean the world to some individuals out there. Not just a simple routine. You want to continue to always have spontaneous moments with your individual. If y'all two are laying in the bed and y'all just roll over and give each other y'all backs, maybe you might want to just hold her in the middle of the night and maybe kiss the back of her ear. Just let her know that you're there. Something spontaneous. Let her feel like y'all are connected. Simple things. I just maybe hugging her when she comes in the door because you're like, I missed you. It's about being spontaneous. If you want to get that flare back, start to catch your mate off guard. Leave them little notes around the place. Let them know that you are thinking about them constantly. You want that spark back. And without that spark, other things can happen. And I will touch on that next. What are the things that may can happen? And I'm pretty sure y'all can guess it, but we will get into that on the next video. But I always want to tell you to respect yourself, because I salute you for always being true to who you are. And always remember to love yourself. And it's Tksmithjr Jr. I'll check you out next time. This is a YOC production. Only God can judge. Only God can judge me. Only God can judge. Only God can judge me. Only God can judge. Only God can judge me. Maybe they don't want to communicate no more. Like in my communication video, I said, you have to be willing to communicate. But this individual don't want to talk to you at all. They keep it really, really short with you. They don't want to go nowhere with you. They make sure that...